all the way to the airport now for the final journey home. So, see you soon, everybody.
Okay, so time to say goodbye to the hotel and the room. Got a convoy of taxis, everyone going together to get through the checkpoints and stuff. And won't be too long now. Right, we're in the car, we're all masked up, ready for the journey. We've got several checkpoints to go through, as we understand. We've got all our paperwork, our certificates, flight details and everything else. And yeah, we're now on our way. We're gonna be leaving. Molly's looking really cool. Are you going to rob a bank or something?
Yeah, I'm not taking no chances.
Right, so that's it for now. We'll, well, I might try and catch a couple of the checkpoints on the way and see what we see and hear and stuff there. Otherwise, planning to sort of document the whole journey home. Yeah, so we'll do that and see you again at a checkpoint or Krabi Airport.
Thanks for everybody's support.
Yeah, thanks for everybody's support. See you soon. Right, so we got to the airport, okay, not too many problems, well, no problems really at all, we come straight through, no real issues there whatsoever. Do you like my new mask? But yeah, we're at the airport now. It's got absolutely no idea what's going on, because well, there just seems to be millions of staff around, but no people. I'm not quite sure where what we're supposed to do, so hopefully we'll find something in a minute. Complete confusion at the moment. Just been given a load of forms to fill out. No instruction what's to go on or why or anything else, but see what absolute fucking scenes going on here at the moment. So basically what we've had to do is fill out a form. You fill out a form, you get a raffle ticket. I think that's, you know, if your number gets pulled, you get your passport back because they're taking the passports away with the forms. Give you a raffle ticket, number 36, and then they call out a number. So they call out number 36, I go to get it, and she's got it in her hand, and then she tells me to go and wait. And I sort of ask where my thing is, you come back later. It's like, I have no idea what's going on, but there is absolutely no system going on here at all. They've got everyone's passports, everyone's getting a bit panicky. They're calling out numbers and no one's getting their passports back. And let's see how this, so the fun never ends. Finally got checked in after our bags were too heavy, not the suitcases but the hand luggage. So we had to move everything out of our hand luggage into our suitcases, but I think we're done now, aren't we?
Yeah,
we're finally done. A little bit warm. And we didn't need the medical certificate, like I said, bit of a scam. So we're on the plane.
Yeah,
your earrings look beautiful, Blue.
You look gorgeous.
On a plane.
And now we're getting the wet wipes out, ready to wipe all the arms of the seats and bits and pieces.
Flight 1 of 3, here we go. Here we are, Bangkok Airport. Just got in from Krabi, got our bits and pieces ready to go. And now we're heading in to the airport, going to departures. For the second day, Bangkok Airport, all checked into our flight with Qatar Airways. Guess what we didn't need? We didn't need the medical certificate. It was a scam. We got scammed in Thailand. Okay, right, we're all checked in, so we're off to immigration now, go through security and wait for a couple of hours for the flight. Hey. see you soon. Okay. Absolutely stripped Bangkok airport bare. There is nothing in any shops, any restaurants. They've literally just stripped everything out, all of the goods, anything that's in there is all wrapped in film. All of this display cabinets and everything, they've taken a lot. All the food outlets, everything's wrapped in cling film or some sort of film. It's absolutely bizarre. Not much chance of us getting any duty free then, or food at this stage, because everything is completely and utterly empty. About 6:30 in the morning, Doha time, so that's about 10:30 in Thailand, and 11:30 I don't know what in the UK. But anyway, we've got the Doha, a little bit of business lounge time, and then a little treat just to stay in isolation. Next flight coming up in around about 3 hours.
Well, here we are, sat in zone 2 now at Doha, waiting for the flight to go back to the UK, London Heathrow. Basically, it's been a horrendous journey, but the last couple of hours has actually been really good fun because Steve treated us to the business lounge, or one of the lounges. So we've had a nice shower, we've had breakfast, had a drink and we feel quite relaxed and ready for our last bit leg.
See you at the other side.
Yes, our last leg now to the UK. This is a bit I've been looking forward to.
Okay, so last video was in Doha and I haven't done one since because just been too tired. So I think it's 28, 29 hours travelling now and we're back, and GoGary airport taxis just picked us up. I'm going to put a link for Gary in the description. So if you want to, if you need anything in Swindon, or you need an airport run, might not need one of them just yet, but you might in the future. Book him up because he's going to get busy now.
Or shopping, picking up, takeaway.
Or shopping. Yeah, he does a nice massage. Does. You can have a soapy one, oily one,
Steve,
whatever you like.
Please stop.
So, yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the end of the video now. We're at Tim and Linda's, we're in Wanborough, and stranded in Thailand is now stranded in Swindon. This is
go.
A long video. Thanks for sticking.
That was our reception. We're not stranded in Swindon. We're lording it in Wanborough.
There we go. There's Tim and Linda, who have kindly offered to put us up for a couple of weeks. And very nice. We're going to be very happy here till October time.